A migraine headache is typically a throbbing or pulsatile discomfort on one side of the head that progresses and gets worse with time. My name is Dr. Julia Lee Jones. I'm a neurologist here at Houston Methodist Hospital. Migraines are genetic. We have an entity called familial hemiplegic migraine that does have a gene that we found, CACNA1A. It's extremely rare, but we know that migraines are typically autosomal dominant, meaning if mom or dad had them, 50-50, the kids will have them. Generally with a migraine headache, it starts slowly, builds, throbs on one side of your head. It hurts to move around, cough, or sneeze. We have to have some degree of lights or noises that will aggravate the headache, like turn down the radio, or some have nausea and may throw up. And a headache is usually gonna last about 4 to 72 hours. So you can imagine having that for 72 hours, that can be very disabling. You miss out on family time. You're probably gonna miss out on work. There are several different migraine triggers, particularly for women. We know globally, probably stress is the number one trigger for migraines. For women, hormonal number two. That would usually go along with either ovulation or menses. We'll find that either 1 or 2 days before your period and 1 to 2 days in, that's when it's most likely to occur. And it does seem to correlate with that drop in estrogen when you have your menses. And then just sometimes routine variables in our day or a mundane change in our routine, something that aggravates our homeostasis, woke up late, stressed, being off with meals, in other words, being late for breakfast or skipping a meal. We often find that that will tip people into their migraine because migraine brains are sort of wired to do that. So usually we have folks try to keep a headache diary, follow some of the apps so you can kind of take a look at things and actually to help be preventative for your migraines to normalize your meals, normalize your sleep, and cardio 3 times a week for 35 minutes. But that being said, we still have a quarter to a third of patients, no matter how perfect they are, they're gonna get a migraine and they need too many migraines, they need preventatives. So the preventatives are usually prescribed for those who are having 6 or 8 plus headache days in a month, but most patients don't need a preventative if they're having, 2 to 4 headache days in a month.